Hello everyone, in this video I will discuss about IP headers. So in my previous video I had discussed about TCP IP suite. So in that you have seen about IP header. So how does IP header look like? It is exactly look like this. You can see the length. It is a length of 32 bits per line. We call it as word. So it is 32 bit words, and these are some mandatory fields. Okay, and here we will have payload or data we want to transmit. Okay, now the minimum length of this header can be 20 byte, and maximum length can be 60 bytes. This VRS is nothing but a version of what IP is used, either it is IPv4 or IPv6 is used. That version is going to be placed here. Then H lane is the header length. Okay, so it is a 4 bit field, and the maximum length of this header can be, so it is 4 bit. So 4 bit means if you put all ones, 4 ones means in decimal it is 15, right? And 32 bit per word. So 32 bit means 4 bytes. So it is going to be 15 into 4 bytes equal to 60 bytes. So this is the reason the maximum header length can be 60 bytes. Okay. Then service type, it is it can be minimized delay, what kind of service you want, and these things. It is 8-bit field. Then comes total length of the header, that is going to be placed here. Then IP identification. Okay, so if it is a fragmented packet means it is part of a single packet, but it is split into small packets or fragments. So how to identify that all the small packets or fragments are belongs to a single packet? So that identification is going to be put here. Then there will be some flag. Okay, it is a 3-bit field. By default all 3 bits are 0, but you can modify them. If it is a reverse, then it will be one. If don't allow to fragment the packet by any device on the network, then you can make the second bit one. If it is already where you have allowed fragmentation, so your packet is fragmented, now this third bit will be put as aim, so that if I receiver get one of the packet, they, by seeing that aim is one, that means that last flag is one, the receiver will understand that there is some sibling or some other fragments which I need to assemble together to get the original packet. Okay, then fragment offset, which is a 13 bit field. Then time to live or TTL is given here. That means how long the packet can travel around the network. How long means here how many hop it can visit maximum. And every time it will visit a new hop, that TTL is going to be decreased. Then protocol, it is an 8-bit field. It can be ICMP protocol, it can be TCP protocol, it can be UDP protocol. And you can see the corresponding number of to each protocol, there is a number which will be placed here. Then header checksum means it will be the checksum will be calculated above the header, which is a 16-bit checksum, which will be placed here, and the receiver can check that whether the calculated checksum of the received packet and this checksum which is sent by the sender are going to be match or not. If they are not matching, then the receiver will understand that their packet is corrupted. Then source IP address, we all know that if it is IPv4, IPv4 is a 32-bit IP address. So it is 32-bit, then destination IP address, then IP option is placed here, if any, then padding, that means these bits are nothing, just to fill up this word to 32 bits. So this padding is here, then payload means the data you want to transmit. So I had spoken about IP fragmentation in between. So what is that? What happens when you are going to transmit one packet over the network? That packet is going to go through or transmit through number of hops or network devices. Now all the network devices are not having the capacity of handling equal size packet. Okay, now say you are sending a packet to the next hop, and the next hop is not capable to handle the size of the packet. So what you will do, you will split your packet, which are called fragmentation, is fragment your packet into smaller packet, then you will send. For that thing, you need to know what is the MTU or maximum transmission unit of the next hop. When you will know, according to that, you will split your packet in comfortable size so that the next hop can handle it. Okay, that is what called fragmentation. So fragmentation can take several time over a packet over the network. Okay, so because every time it will get a new device which is having less capability of handling the length of packet, that will be again going to be fragmented. So three fields of IP headers are there related to fragment, that is IP identification, I have already told you, then fragmentation offset and flags, that D and M flag. If you go back to the slides, you will find. Thank you for watching.